Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. In this video, inshallah, we will look at another mosque that Dan Gibson claimed is among the early surviving mosque. And he also claimed that this mosque is facing Petra. Before we begin listening to Dan Gibson's description of the mosque, I would like to emphasize that Dan Gibson referred to this as a mosque.
If we go to the earliest mosques that were built, where we can identify their direction of prayer, we can after the Mosque of the Two Qiblas in Saudi Arabia, there are a further 11 early surviving mosques that we can research. 100% of all the surviving mosques we have located so far.
Now let's go and listen to Dan Gibson's description of the Qibla of this mosque.
Around 700 AD, or about 80 years after the founding of Islam, the Abbas family built a large manor house here. This house had no special mosque area. Rather, the faithful would line up here in the courtyard to pray. This house has a Qibla direction, but it is not towards Jerusalem.
First of all, he said that this is a mosque, and this is among the early surviving mosque. And now he's saying that this is a palace or a house. And he also said that there was no mosque area. But somehow he was able to speculate where and to which direction Muslims who lived in the palace would pray, which is rather odd. I mean, look at the site. How can someone look at this site and find out which room the Muslims were praying in and to which direction? Also, how did he know which wall was the Qibla wall if there was no mihrab? Now, if you want to ask how did I know that there was no mihrab, it is Dan Gibson who said in his website, in the page of the description of this mosque, that there was no mihrab. So amazingly, looking at this site, Dan Gibson knew where was the prayer room. He also knew which direction the Muslim prayed towards. And this is not based on any archaeological evidence. It's his mere speculations. So first of all, this is not a mosque. This is a palace or a house. Second, there is no way to find out if there was a mosque inside this house. And even if you wanted to assume that there was a mosque there, there is no way you'll find which direction they were facing. Now, another problem for Dan Gibson is that archaeologists, after they discovered this palace, they also discovered that there was a nearby mosque, which was built at the same time, and which was facing probably Mecca, or close to the direction of Mecca. This is a study by John P. Ollison, who was cited by Dan Gibson in his Qibla Tool website. And here they are saying the following. A large residence, qasr, and small mosque, masjid, excavated between 1992 and 2002. Archaeological finding and information from early Arab historians led us to identify them as the qasr and masjid of the Abbasids. And you can even see the mosque from Dan Gibson Qibla Tool website. Now someone might ask, did Dan Gibson talk about this mosque? Well, not in his YouTube documentary, but in his website, he talked about this small mosque. Let's go and read what he said about this mosque. Let's read what he said in the last line of this paragraph. Later, a small outside mosque was built with a Qibla pointing closer to Mecca. Dan claimed that this small mosque was built later. And before the building of this small mosque, there was a prayer room area inside the palace, which was facing Petra. First of all, there is no evidence from Islamic sources or non-Islamic sources that the small mosque was built later. And second, there is no evidence whatsoever from Islamic or non-Islamic sources that the palace had a prayer room. Let's read what Dan Gibson said in his response to one of the comments. And let's read from the fifth line. I recognize that Dr. Ollison did not have the data that I gathered. Therefore, he could not compare the Humayma Qasr Qibla with the other Qasr Qiblas of the period. From my survey of mosques of the first two centuries of Islam, it appears that all of the early Qasrs building themselves were oriented in a specific direction. It appears to me that all of them had prayer rooms or areas in them used for prayer, but none of the earliest qasr included a mihrab. So here Dan explicitly explains why he disagrees with the findings of Dr. Allison and explains that his claim that there was a prayer room in that palace is just based on his own opinion. It's not supported by any archaeologist. Now think about the level of dishonesty that this guy reached. He found a palace, and next to the palace there is a small mosque, and the mosque is facing south, the palace is facing north. He completely ignored the mosque and claimed that the mosque was built later without any evidence, and then made another baseless claim that there was a prayer room inside this palace and the prayer room was facing Petra. That's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and click the like button if you find the content beneficial. جزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.